Hello everyone, very good morning and welcome to the OData Made Easy course. In today's session, we are going to discuss about concurrency control and entity tag. Concurrency control. Concurrency is a situation where multiple people are accessing the resources at the same time. How to control that? And entity tag is a technique through which you are going to control the concurrency control. We are going to see this one in more detail, but before going ahead, let's have a quick recap what we have done in the last class. In last class, we have seen the message handling using the various techniques, right? Like if you have to display the exception, how you can display. If you have to simply display the message, how you can simply display the message. If you want to add the message in the message header, how you can do using the MO context. So these are some important stuff we have discussed. We have also discussed there are two types of exception. One is the business exception and another is the technical exception. So business exception, that means if you are having some data related issue, there you can display the business exception, like if you are having some BAPI return value, right? So there you can raise the business exception. But if you are having some technical issue like formatting kind of issue, you know, there you probably like or data type of issue, you can display the technical exception. This is the technical exception. I need to correct it. You know, I will correct it. I will update this one. Okay. And SAP message here, right? If you want to display, just I have shown you. Now let's go and see about how we can, you know, how we can control the concurrency using the entity tag. So first we will understand some terms over here. Concurrency control. Concurrency control. Concurrency control. Concurrency, the meaning of concurrency means accessing a resource at a same time, you know, accessing a resource at a same time by different people. This is the meaning of a concurrency. And concurrency control means if such situation is going to occur, how you are going to control them, right? So such a situation can be controlled using the entity tag technique. So what is entity tag? So entity tag is like a identity card, okay? Pahchan patra. Entity tag is like a identity card. So this is a mechanism or technique. This is a mechanism or technique through which you are going to perform the concurrency control. Concurrency control. That means if multiple people are accessing the same resources, then entity tag is a way to handle the situation. Okay. So hope you know situation. The basic theoretical part is now clear. All right. This is the basic part which we should know. Now let's go and see one example. Okay, one example we are going to see, and let me share my screen over here. So what's the example actually? What we are going to do here, you have a, you know, here you have the backend, right? Here you have the backend, and in backend you have, let's suppose you have a table. In backend, let's suppose you have a table. So let's suppose you have the table like this. Okay, here you have the product ID, and here you have the product category. And here you have price. Here maybe you have the name, and here you can have the description. So these are the different, you know, fields in this particular table. Now here you have the product ID one, and here you have two category, maybe advertising category, and maybe here some other category. Price 200, and here let's suppose you have 225. Name is laptop, and here maybe you are having desktop, something like that. Okay, so this is the description: big laptop and big desktop. So just I have prepared some dummy kind of data over here, right? And let's suppose you have a user, okay? You have a user one over here. You have a user one over here, okay? You have user one over here, and this particular user is reading this particular record, okay? This particular record is being read by user one. At the same time, you know, the same record at the same time is going to be read by the another user, let's say the user two. Okay, at the same time, this is the user one and this is the user two. Okay. So, fine. So when they are reading, there is no issue. User one is reading this particular record, there is no issue. Okay. Now this user one is trying to update the price over here. Let's suppose 300, right? So here this user one is doing this particular stuff at what's the time? 8:22, right? You can see here it's the 8:22 a.m. At this particular time, user is trying to, you know, update something. So let's suppose he has updated the price from 200 to 300. This is what that user has done, right? So you can see the green one is updating the green one. Okay. At the same time, the user two, you know, what they are doing, they are trying to update this category from AD to PD, something like this, you know, some another category from AD to PD, right? So maybe for this user two, we can give some different color. And this is for the PD, okay? So now what will happen? User one is trying to update this 300, that means from earlier it was the 200, from 200 to 300, and this, you know, and user 2 is trying to update from AD to PD. Okay, now here suppose user 1 has updated the record from AD to from 200 to 300 at click on the save button. Okay, from the UI, this is happening from UI 5, from UI side. This is happening from UI 5 side. Okay, and you know that this connection is based upon the REST concept, right? OData. They have got the data in the browser on the page. Okay. This user also has got the data in the browser on the page, and in between you are having the what? OData service, through the OData service. OData service is based upon what? REST protocol, stateless. Once they receive the data, there is no command on this particular record. Okay. They also, once receive the data, there is no command on particular record, means in backend, right? Stateless. Okay. Now, AD to PD is done by user 2 and click on the save button, right? So what it will do, it will save as a PD. Same time, what they have done for this user, still it will be the AD only, right? For this user, if you just come here and put it, for this user, still it will be the previous record only, right? Still it will be the previous record only and 200 only, right? But this user has changed the PD and saved, right? Saved. So what? In the database now, you are having the PD and you are having 200, right? The old record. So in the database, now you are having the PD and 200, because from AD to PD, this user 2 has changed, right? Now, this user 1 is doing this 300, right? And click on the save button, right? User 1 did not change AD to PD. Still, for user 1, it was AD. So what will happen in this case? Again, in your database, previous user, you know, changes will be overwritten, right? So still, because for this user 1, you are having a still AD, and now, you know, he has changed the 200 to 300, right? And laptop, big laptop, all these things is going to remain same. So what happens? User 2 changes has been overwritten with the user 1 changes, right? So PD is now not there in your database. You are again having only AD and 300, right? So how to avoid such a situation, right? How to avoid such a situation? So user 2 is thinking that his changes has been saved, right? User 1 first retrieved the data, and because he retrieved the data and there he got AD, right? And from 200 to 300 he changed. So from front end, when he's supplying, when he's submitting the data, again AD is coming and overwriting the PD record, right? So hope you understood the scenario, how it is, you know, leading to inconsistency, how the data is getting overwritten, right? So if you don't have any locking mechanism, if you don't have any concurrency control, right, then it will, if you don't have any concurrency control, then it will lead to inconsistency unknowingly, right? Unknowingly. So you can see that still user 2 will be thinking that his data has been, you know, saved properly, but by, you know, mistake, user 1 has, you know, updated his record. So how to avoid this situation? Is it clear? Are you able to understand what I'm trying to did you understand how it is leading to inconsistency? Was I able to make it clear? Okay, thanks for the confirmation. Yeah. So if you don't have any concurrency control, then it will lead to inconsistency. So how you can do? So see how we can do. So when say user 2 was first changing the data, right? So if you have some tag, right? So let's suppose there is some tag here. You have some tag number. Tag is nothing but a number, okay? A stamp, a number. Tag is nothing but a stamp or number. Let's suppose this tag number is some number 1000, let's suppose. So when user 2 is retrieving the data, this particular record, at that time, if system is going to give you some tag number, that tag number should be a field, you know, that tag number can be a field from this database itself, from this table itself, or that tag number you can handle using the different table also. So all those techniques we are going to see here. Just to understand, there is a tag number field in this table itself. Let's assume that, okay? And in that table, you have maintained this entry 1000, okay? 1000 entry you have maintained. Or maybe this tag number you can maintain with the date and time stamp, okay? Date and timestamp. So currently, how much? What is the date? 2021-09-29, and then the time is 08-31. Okay. So let's suppose this is your tag number. This particular. Sorry. So in this table, you are having one more, you know, just let me add one more field in this. Okay, here you have changed at, let's suppose you are having the changed at. So in this changed at, you have this particular tag over here. Okay. This is the particular tag. Now, so the tag you are taking from a field from this particular table itself. Okay. So when the user 2 is retrieving the data, he is getting the data with the tag, whatever you have the field changed at here, right? Now he's going to change the data, right? He's going to change the data along with the tag number, right? So because you have the date and time stamp, certainly when he is going to change the data, again, this changed at time will be updated. Let's suppose this time is going to update from 08 to 09 and 32, okay? And user 1 also, when they retrieved the data earlier, they will be having the same tag number, right? Earlier, because same time they were retrieving the data, right? Now when user 2 is updating this particular record, this PD from AD to PD, this system what doing? This tag number they are matching with this particular here, you know, changed at record. If they're finding that, okay, this is the same, then they are allowing to update. Okay, and now from AD to PD is now updated. Now, this user one is trying to change the price from 200 to 300. So he has changed the price over here on the UI side and now clicking on the save button. As soon as the control will come to the backend, this tag will try to match with the tag which you have selected, changed at over here, right? But this is the different tag. Here what you have and here what you have, this is the different. So system will reject, system will tell that no, whatever you have the data at front end at this point of time, you don't have the latest data. You know, you there is something changed in backend. So please first retrieve the latest data and there you change. So what the this user will do, again, he will retrieve the latest data. So now this user two has already changed from AD to PD. So when user one is going to retrieve the data, he will get the latest data with PD. Okay, so he will now get the latest data with PD. And now when he is going to change the, you know, 200 to 300, right? And again, he will get the tag also updated tag over here, right? He will get the updated tag over here. And when he will click on the save button, this tag will come over here and it will try to match over here, right? Both is going to be same this time. So now you have the data PD and the updated record from 200 to 300. So by this way, you are not overwriting his existing, you know, a record which was already PD, right? So now you are having the PD and 300, right? So by this way, using the tag, using the entity tag, you are able to handle the concurrency control. Is it clear with this example? Did you understand what I'm trying to tell? How using the entity tag, you know, you can avoid overwriting the entry. So if you can confirm, or do you want me to repeat over here? If you understood, then I will go ahead and I will show you the example or not. Do you want me to repeat over here? You can simply tell me. Okay, fine. Good. Very good. So like that, you will have to ask whenever you don't understand. See, what I'm trying to tell, in the earlier situation, till last point, you understood, you know, that how inconsistency were happening, right? When user two was doing the changes, then after that, user one was having the same data. See, once again, I'm going to repeat. User two, what it will do? User two will first retrieve the data at the same time, and user one is going to retrieve the data at the same time at the UI level. So what you have the data over here, you have the, let me delete this one and just copy this and paste it over here. So this is the data for user one, okay? This is the data for user one. For user two also, you are having the same data, right? For user two, because both the data they are retrieving at the same time. Here I'm going to, so original data was ED, AD, and here the original price was 200. So for them also, they will be having the AD, and for user two will be also having the AD. For user one also will be having the 200. For user two also will be having the 200. So this is what the actual data for user one and user two. Now from UI side, user one, see, and here you have the entity tag, okay? Here you have the entity tag. This is because changed at field you have marked here as a entity tag. Okay, so this particular timestamp is behaving like a entity tag. Now user one is changing the data from AD to PD. Okay. And click on the save button. So what it will happen that this complete record, you know, this complete record will come over here. But before updating it, this particular record, you know, this particular entity tag and this particular entity tag will be matched. And if this is going to be the same, then only the complete record will be updated. So the very first time, because user one is first updating the data, you know, user one is first updating the data, what it will do here, copy this one and paste it over here. It will be updated because this and this is going to be the same, right? So it will be updated over here. I have just copied and pasted. Now, user two, this user, right, is trying to. So user has, user one has done what? User one has done just, you know, let me do change the sequence over here, because here, you know, the different sequence I have put it. So in order to, yeah. So user two has changed from AD to PD. Here we have the user two from AD to PD. And this data has been, you know, updated over here because this timestamp and this timestamp, that means this entity tag and this entity tag are matching with each other, right? There is no problem. But, you know, but when you are updating, this changed at time is going to get updated. This is now not going to remain same because you are updating this record. So it will be updated with the latest, you know, time. Maybe it's a 10, something like 3, 8. Okay, like this, it has been updated now. So now the user one is again trying to update this price from 200 to 300, right? 300. So when they are trying to update this particular record, now this entity tag and this entity tag is not matched. So once they click on the save button or submit button, all this record will come from front end to back end, right? And here they will see that this record and this record is not matching. Then they will reject the request and tell that, no, this is not matching. You will not be able to, means they will tell that, you know, this is not the latest record, right? Technically, they will tell something like the precondition not matched, but you will have to give some custom message. You know, you will have to convert into some custom message at the UI and you will have to handle accordingly and tell that, you know, that this is not the latest record. First, get the latest record and then you have to update, because here you can see that this is the entity tag and this is the entity tag is now not matching. So it will not allow you to update the price from 200 to 300, right? Getting my point? Now is it clear, right? Now hope you understood. It will be rejected. So now user one will again fetch the latest record, this record, right? Copy this one and paste it over here. So this record they will retrieve. And now they are having the latest entity tag, right? You can see. And this time, if they are going to update the price from 200 to 300 and click on the submit button, then this record will come and, you know, updated over here because this and this is matching at this point of time. Okay. And now you can see that this has been updated from 200 to 300, right? And both didn't face any issue also. No one's got, you know, any kind of trouble, right? User one also record got successfully updated from 200 to 300 and user two record also got successfully updated from AD to PD. But in earlier case, if you were not using the entity tag, you know, one of the previous user records was getting overwritten with the latest user. Why? Because at the same time they retrieved the data at the UI side, right? And because they were not having the updated data, and when they were clicking on the save button, you know, it was overwriting. Okay, so good. So by this way, this is the concurrency control, and here let's go and see how we can do this one. Okay, so there are so this is the concept behind the entity tag. Now it depends on you how you are going to handle. So we will be discussing the two methods. Okay, and so today I will be discussing one method and tomorrow another method. Go to SEGW transaction and entity tag. For entity tag, we can choose this ZODATA easy and quick. Okay. For entity tag, we can use this ZODATA easy and quick over here. Or maybe what I can do that, I will quickly create one project. Okay. I will quickly create one project. Let me create this ZODATA e-tag. ODATA e-tag. And here inside the model. Okay. So from this itself, I can copy this, you know, under the property, this product ID and everything is there. Can I copy this? Yes, it's allowing me, and right click and paste it over here. Okay. So we have this header data. And just wanted to change its name. So let me do one thing. I will delete this one and I will create one entity type over here. So with the proper naming, you know, it's a header data. It's a little confusing. So product, I'm giving the product name, create the entity set over here. And we have the properties. So this property, the same property, I'm going to keep it. So copy this and paste it over here. So this looks good now, all right? This is good. And for this product, this is fine. And the entity set, this is the product set which we are having. This also, you know, yeah, this is fine, right? Header data set and all everything is now set. So the simple example, and now what actually we'll have to do here, in order to have the entity tag, you know, in order to have the entity tag implemented, what you will have to do that, in this entity type, you can double click over here. And here you have a property called e-tag. Okay, so you can click on this and see from this category, currency code and all, you will have to choose a field which is going to work for you as a entity tag, right? Which is going to work for you as a entity tag. But here you don't have any such field, right? You can see the type code, all these things is like, you know, so the best field would have been the change at, means which will contain the latest time stamp, right? Change at. So maybe what I will do that, I will add a field called change at, but that again, you know, I want to keep it simple. Okay, let me keep it simple. Otherwise, you know, it will start again having the complex code writing. So instead of this, what we can do that this product ID, just give me a second. Header data we are having BAPI EPM product header, fine. So the product header we have. And now, if we are going to pass, okay, so let me do one thing. Here itself, I'm going to add a change. Here itself, one property called, let me go into right click and change option is not coming. Double click over here. And from here, we can add a property called etag. Okay, a property called etag, or maybe better, let's put it changed at, because each product is having a field called, if you just go to the table SE16 and here you see SNWD_PD, it is having a field called changed at, okay, created by, changed by, and changed at, right? So change that. This particular field we can use for the purpose of entity tag, because this will contain your latest data, latest change that. So if something you are going to, update, this will be automatically updated. Okay. So this is what changed at field I'm just considering over here. Come here and you have the date and time, right? Select this date and time. So this is a date and time only, right? Or something else. Let's go and check it. /NSE11 changed at looking for the field changed at this one. Okay. Change, this is of decimal 21, fine. And here we are having, a date and time. Let me see if you have something like, we have the decimal over here, numeric values with the fixed precision and a scale. This maybe also can be used, but date and time is also fine. Okay, date and time also fine, or we can try with the EDM dot. Okay. Because here, the data type, if you see here, this is the decimal 21, right? This is the decimal 21. Decimal 21, UTC, timestamp, YYI, MMM, all these things, right? In this format, it is coming. So it's the timestamp format only. So let's keep the date and time. Okay. It looks good now. Just click on the save button. And the changed at we have now at this point of time. So what I did, I have created a entity type product and it is having the different property like this. I have created one more field called changed at so that it will suffice the purpose of entity tag, okay? And then go to the product over here and now you are having a valid field, right? You should have some field which will suffice the purpose of, the entity tag. So changed at, right? So this will handle the latest, the date and time value. And now I think it's good. Select this one and click on this generate local object. And now it will generate the DPC, DPC extension, MPC and MPC extension, right? So what I will do now, go to /OSEGW and sorry, go to AC24. And under the DPC extension for this particular ZCL underscore DPC extension, go into the change mode and remove this filter. Go to last and define a method getEntity. Okay, one method will be sufficient in order to show this. So define this. And here, the code I will copy from this, okay? So to get the data, I will copy the code from any of my previous example, okay? So here also we have the ZO data update demo, right? For ET underscore products. So come here, and from here, I'm going to copy this. And maybe directly I can go from here. Okay. So methods redefinition and get entity. Copy the entire code from here. PEPM product ID, right? It looks, let me check how this code is actually. So I need to do little correction over here, copy this one, and I will paste it over here. So ls underscore head, PEPM product header, ls underscore product ID, this looks good. This I don't want, and return all this is fine. Single star here, I want to get the data using this. Okay, I want to get the data using this, and here under ER underscore entity, okay, that the changed at also we are having, right? This field also I would like to populate with the latest changed at date, because this, when you are using this PEPM product get detail, you are not going to get the changed at information over here. Okay, I will show you. Here you can see that there is no changed at field, right? There is no changed at field. And that's the purpose we have added manually over there, right? So changed at, you will have to get manually. So this, then you'll have to keep this one actually, and ls underscore header data, ls underscore head to ER entity, that is fine. I will mark it the ls underscore header, ls underscore header, ls underscore header, and here this is for the purpose of, you know. So I will directly take it this ls underscore, maybe the changed at only I want, okay? The changed at only I want. So just to remove this and select single changed at from SNWD into, I will use the data keyword, and then LV changed at, CA changed at, and this LVCA directly I can put it over here. So changed at will be required actually, right? Because it's serving the serving the purpose of entity tag. So you must have to fill that one, right? A unique value you must have to fill, right? So it's selling into at the rate and data. A new syntax is used, okay, at the rate. Invalid value can result when rounding. Okay, that's fine. Rounding is also okay for me. Here, activate this one. And this looks good now. Now, Go here and for the product update entity set, we are going to, you know, copy this, and come back and product update entity, right? Redefine this one. One is the get entity I will require to get the data, and another method I will require for the purpose of updation. Okay. So I have copied this. Reading the data over here, that is fine. Here I'm putting category, type, code, description, supplier ID, supplier name. This is also fine. It will be automatically updated with the latest timestamp. And once everything is fine, I want to get the data back. Okay. So maybe this particular, you know, portion you can remove. Not required at this point of time, at least. This also is not there. Check the syntax now and activate this. Okay. So if something is, you know, maybe you would like to have the successful message. So for that purpose, if LT underscore return is initial, and if so, for that purpose, we can have MO underscore context. The message handling part just I am taking care. Get message container. And in this, you can add the message from BAPI. You can add directly message from this BAPI and put this LT underscore return over here. And add this as a BAP true so that it will be added there in the, you know, header. And IP message target, maybe something. Just I'm giving the test over here. PTP into check the syntax. LT return is not type compatible with the formal parameter. Okay. So I will be passing multiple messages we are having, right? So add messages from BAPI instead of, you know. So remove this. Control space, add messages from BAPI, this one. Not because that was expecting to give me the single, you know, value. So I'm passing the multiple values. So I'm using messages instead of message. And here we have the BAP underscore true. Pretty printer, check the syntax and activate this one. Good. Now, you know, it looks good for me now. We have already generated the service, right? Come here and slash in SCGW once again. ZO data e tag. This is what we have. Go to the service maintenance and you will have to register the service. Click on this register and one time activity, this you must have to perform, otherwise you will not be able to call the service. And then click on this SAP gateway client, click on this yes button, and let's see if you are getting something over here. Something we're getting, let's see that if you are getting the metadata or not. So okay, this is not implemented, that is fine. You know, we have implemented a method to get the single product, right? This, to get the single product. So for single product, we need to pass a valid value for the single product. Slash O SC16 SNWD underscore PD and one valid product. Maybe I can take the first one itself, ST1000. Copy this. ST-1000. So this I would require this I would require maybe several times. So having as a backup, click on this execute, and this time I'm expecting to have the record. And you can see that we are having the record over here, right? All this product URL, category, name, description, weight unit, all these things. Where is the changed at? That I require at any cost, right? Changed at, not getting over here, changed at, why? Let's do one thing, I'll put the breakpoint. That is the important field, right? That is the important field for me. So product update entity. No, this is not the one actually. Here get entity, and here we are. Let me, that field itself is not coming, right? You can see that changed at field is not coming over here. It should come, right? It should come. Let me check what's the wrong going on. OData eTax service, right? This is fine. Inside the OData eTax service, we have this product and changed at, we have at last, right? EDM date and time, all these things is fine. Changed at here also looks good. This field is also not, you know, mandatory one, but this is the date and time field maybe. So go into the change mode. This is okay. This looks good. This looks good. Let me regenerate, go into the change mode, and I will regenerate the service once again, because I'm not getting this, you know, changed at that field I want to have, right? That field I want to have. So the product ID over here, type, category, supplier, all these things, currency. Yeah, it's coming here actually, sorry. My mistake, actually changed at is coming here. You can see that it's coming, right? This field is coming over here. This is what I was looking, it's coming, okay? Now, this is one thing. You are getting this data over here, right? Changed at. Now you want to update the record, okay? So use as a request, and you would like to update the record. So for that purpose, see, and one more thing over here, like, you know, it's returning you the entity tag also. So where you can find the entity tag, you can find in the header, okay? At two places, you can find the entity tag. So I will show you one by one. Here at the header, this is one, this is one. This is your entity tag actually. This is your entity tag, right? So when you are going to update it, you need to have this entity tag. From here, you will have to pass so that system will understand, okay, you are updating with this particular entity tag, you know? So if nothing is changed, someone has done already before you, suppose you also have retrieved and some other person also would have retrieved with the same entity tag, right? And if the other person would have been already updated with the same entity tag, then the new changed at time will be updated with the latest one. I will show you, you know, come here and just close this. Come here and maybe you will be able to understand better in the question mark dollar format equals to JSON format, okay? So press F8, and here you can see that it looks now better, right? This is your entity tag, okay? Copy this one and paste it, this entity tag. At one more place you have, from where you can get the entity tag, this one, header. This also you can copy and you can paste it. right? Okay. You can see that both entity tag is having little difference. Okay. Both the entity tag is having little a difference. Here in beginning, it is having this sign. Here you have this a date, time, you know, you have the difference. Which entity tag? However, both is the entity tag, right? This also and this also. This some extra character is coming over here in order to, you know, map it over here, right? Because here you are getting at the header level, and here they are converting some of the characters, you know. I don't remember exactly how the character conversion happens here. So better, you know, you are supposed to use this entity tag. If you use this one, you can come into trouble. You may fall into trouble, you know. However, both are entity tag. But remember, as a thumb rule, as a rule of thumb, you remember, you must have to use this entity tag every time so that you will not come across a, you know, any a bad situation, or you will not come across any problem. So this is the one, you know, you will have to use. Generally in beginning, people falls into trouble. They start using this entity tag, you know, and this entity tag most of the time does not work, you know, or maybe anytime it does not work. It does not work, you know, it does not work. So better you use this one. So for a fresher kind of people, you know, they keep on using this one. They don't understand. They do the Google and all, no much material on this, you know, on this and this. So they don't get there also some answer, right? Why they are not able to operate. I will show you what actually you are going to get, have the problem. So first I will show you with this entity tag that it will not update, right? But when you will try with this, it will. This entity tag is the, you know, the correct one, the header one you will have to use. This is the header one. This is also entity tag, but this is coming under the body section, right? This is coming under here. You can see that this is coming under in this body section here. In this sense, I'm talking, okay? Now, you will have to put the update request, right? You are going to update. So one user is going to. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to open one more session. Okay, I'm going to open one more session slash, and I'll close the extra session. I don't, but do one thing. First, let me see like this update and all is working properly or not, right? Then that particular stuff I will do, okay? Now, remove this one because, so this also I may have to use multiple times. I will copy and paste it over here. And now we have to remove this question mark dollar format equal to JSON. Not required because you are not going to put the put request, right? And here from this type code from PR, I'm going to change this AD, right? And click on this execute. Click on this execute. Remove this one. Press F8. Remove this. Yesterday I was doing some debugging. Still, that, you know, breakpoint is here, and you can see that it's telling precondition required, right? What it is telling? It is telling precondition required. That means it is telling, you know, you will not be able to simply update this. System is telling you will not be able to simply update the is. It's telling you must have to pass the entity tag. Here you see the data service request is required to be conditional. Now the put request directly is not going to work. Even your control, right? The your control to update the data is not coming over here, right? In this method, right? Here the control is not coming. Again, I'm executing, see? Before going here itself, you know, system is rejecting, right? A standard program is rejecting your request and it's telling no, false, not possible. You must have to, you know, meet its precondition. So what's the precondition over here? It's telling use the if match condition. From here you can copy this one and add a value for if match. Copy and see, I'm going to use the one which I'm telling you, you are supposed to use this one, right? So that we will not get the error at least, okay? Because if you use this body, there is no guarantee, there is no guarantee. And we are not supposed to use that one. Use this header one. This entity tag is the perfect one. Here I have copied and pasted this, okay? And click on this OK button. You can see that under the if match, it has been added successfully, right? And now if you click on this execute button, see how it happens. You can see that this time it has triggered this one, right? Put operation, correct? And press F6, F6, and here it's coming, right? And what it is doing then? After doing, see, again, I'm pressing F8. So after fetching the data, means it's getting the data from there and matching. And once it is matched, right? Once it is matched, then it is coming over here in the update, and now it will update, okay? Now it will update. So just to press F6, let us see everything is going fine or not. So F6, LT return should be, So this is the update module. If you want to disable, come here and click on this save button, okay? Press F8. And LT return should be blank. Yes, that means successfully updated. Okay, successfully updated. And here we are handling some message. There you can see that, right? Here you can see that it's working fine, right? It's working fine. And this means 204, you got it over here. 204, you got it over here. That means it got successfully updated. It got successfully updated. So what I will do that, go and open, here you can, just refresh it. See here, from PR past AD, right? So now this is AD, correct? Now go to /NSCGW one more time. That means just I wanted to check, the update is working or not with the entity tag. Okay, one more thing over here. I was emphasizing on this part that if you will be using this entity tag of the body, no, it will not work. Okay. So that also I will show you. Okay. This will not work. But now tell me one answer over here. My question is, again, if I'm going to change this one from AD to PR, okay. And here I'm using the entity tag, right, from the header itself, from this portion, right? From this portion I have copied here, right? And this, the same entity tag I'm using over here. Will it work? Can you tell me? Will it work? Just write here your answer in the chat box. Will it work? Yes, very good, very good, very good. So you people are getting the concept now. Awesome. Awesome, Ramesh. Thank you. So you got the concept. So this should be the updated one. It will not work. It will tell that precondition mismatched, something like that. So let's go and click on this execute button. So first, again, it's going to get that one, right? That particular changed it value, and it will match with that, right? It will match with that. And the matching will fail and it will not go into update. See, matching got failed and precondition failed and it didn't go into the update section. It didn't go into the update section, right? It didn't go into the update section. You can see that. See here, it's giving you that precondition failed. So what you will have to do once again, you will have to first get the latest record, get it, right? But now, again, one question. If you try to get the latest record, will you be able to get the latest record with this with this if match condition, can you guess? Can you just guess? There is no right or wrong answer. Can you just guess? Okay, very good. You have given the answer as yes, but unfortunately, it's not going to fetch because what you are using over here, you know, you are using the entity tag, right? And this is not the latest entity tag because this is not the latest entity tag. What will happen that, you know, it will again tell you, it will again tell you that this is not the latest record. You will not be able to fetch. So what you will have to do, you'll have to remove this first. So from UI5 side, again, like, you know, I don't have very good idea at this point of time how this get handled from the UI side or UI automatically handled, you know. But here from gateway, you don't have to pass this if match, okay? You don't have to pass this if match, okay? And now if you click on this execute, it will give you the data. You can see that now it's giving you the data with the latest entity tag, right? With the latest entity tag, it's giving you the data. Question mark. Dollar format equals to JSON. Okay, format equals to, you can see that. You are getting that data over here, right? You are getting that, and this is your latest. See here, today's date is coming automatically. That's the benefit of BAPI. BAPI will take care of the latest date and time of updating the data, right? Now, again, like, you know, if you will try to update, it will allow you to update. And you will have to choose this particular, you know, entity tag. Don't choose this one, otherwise, you know, it'll come into trouble and you will keep on thinking why it's not working. I will show you. No, so see this. So for this e tag, what is a property? This is your property. This is your property for this e tag. Okay, this is your property. So copy this one and click on this plus button. And if you put if match and paste it over here, this one I'm doing this time, and you will see that it will create the issue. Use as request, and from this time it's AD. Now I'm just changing from AD to PR. Okay. Or other thing also you can change. There is no issue. Supplier, all these things you can change based upon your requirement, and click on this port. Now click on this execute. See here, it's telling that precondition failed, right? Precondition, it's telling the precondition failed. Why? Because this is not the correct entity, you know, tag. So the correct entity tag, you will have to get it. So again, I'm clicking on this execute button, press F8, and the correct entity tag from here, you will have to get. Very important step, otherwise, you know, it may come into trouble. So I have already copied, so no need of pasting and all this. I'm not going to use again that. Click on this plus button. Go here and we can change also. Change this one. And click on this put, use as request. AD to PD I'm simply doing. Or if you want to change the price also, you can change from 1700 to 999. And click on this execute button. Some internal server error is coming. Why? Internal server error means some exception. Internal server error means some exception it has occurred. So what I will do that, you know, but there is a probability that it would have updated the data. Though internal server error is coming, you know, so maybe this internal server error is coming after updation. So in order to make sure, we can go to the database layer, and there we can just give a look, because if it is updated, then again that entity tag is not going to work anymore. For that purpose, actually I'm checking. Okay, so this is the AD, still the price is 1700. That means that is not updated. That means, you know, not updated. Okay, let me check for AD, PR and AD actually. PR and AD we are having, and we are so it's the PR and AD. So we can pass it from PR, okay? And now this time it should update. Click on this execute button, but this time also it's giving you the error. Why? Oh, sorry. This you don't have to pass, right? Question mark dollar format. This much only will have to pass it. Okay. Click on this execute button. Yeah. And press F8. F8. Yeah. And it got updated. So whatever is doing the mistake, question mark dollar format equal to JSON, that you don't have to pass. This much only you will have to pass with the key in the update request. And here I was passing, you know, the PD, which was not the valid one. So there also it would have been creating the issue, right? So both the correction I have done for, you know, and this is what this and this was creating the issue. Now fine, it got updated. It got updated. So the price what you was updating $9.99, let's go and check it, okay? So directly I can check it from here, right? Press F8. So precondition failed. Okay, you'll have to remove this. Just remove and click on this execute. Press F8 and let's see. So PR is updated, right? And price is 1700, right? This was not updated. Okay. So for this purpose, actually, this was not updated. I know why it is not updated, because we are not passing the price information over here, right? We are not telling to the system to update the price. So how it will update, correct? You'll have to tell to update the price. So here, now this price, okay? So price now I'm marking to update, and this time like, so you'll have to, you know, handle it over here actually. What are the things you want to update? All these things here, you have many things, right? So if you want to update all these things everywhere, XXXX under the header data X as the BAPI concept, you will have to, you know, do. So now I have marked that price to update, and now it will update the price also. So let me quickly, you know, show you that maybe, so that it will get confirmed that it's working fine, right? So use as a request, and you know, here get, this is the entity tag, control C, and click on this plus button, and if a match, okay, and from PR, I'm going to do this one as AD. And here we will be putting the price $9.99. And click on this put. Looks good over here. And click on this execute. Okay, press F8. Coming F6, price this time I'm marking X. Looks good, LT return is zero. That is fine, that means this time your price would have been, you know, updated. So now remove this if match, come here, click on this execute and press F8. Expecting it to be here $9.99, okay? And you can see that price is now updated. Fine. So you understood how the entity tag means. Entity tag, once you are going to update anything, right? Once you are going to update anything, your entity tag is going to be changed. And after that, the same entity tag will not be able to be used by another person. Okay. So 2 more minutes, and I will quickly show you how, suppose 2 different persons have been logged in, how it's going to reject that. Okay, so quickly we are going to see this. First, we got the data over here already, right? Let's suppose this is one system. Now everything we have tested and everything is working fine. So close this session and this also. Let it be this. So that I will be able to open the gateway client. OData e tag. And here the product we are having, right? The changed ad. This is fine. We don't have to go over there. Here, actually, remove this. Come here directly. Let's suppose this is one person. This is one person here. They have logged in. See here, S18-1. Okay, S18-1. So this is one person and another person. One more person. Okay, this is one person. One more person. Come here and again click on this SAP Gateway client. So this is the four. One is one here, and one is four. So two person is logged in now. Okay. So the person one is retrieving the data now. Okay. So they are retrieving the data now. Control V. And the person two also is retrieving the data at the same point. Okay, so person two data. And now I don't require this breakpoint and all, right? So I will be removing this, so it will be a smooth. Okay, so this is the person two. Here, see the four in the fourth session, person two have been, and in the first session, person one. Click on this execute. So both has retrieved the data at same time. Okay, let's suppose like that. Now, this person one is going to update the data. Okay, so put use as a request and change some data. Maybe I'm going to change some data here. This price $8.99. Okay, this people has changed the data. And I'm using the entity tag concept. So for that purpose, I'll be copying this Control Y, Control C, and click on this plus button. If match, Control V, enter. So this is the person one. Okay. This is the person one. And click on this execute. Oh, sorry. This will have to remove, right? This question mark dollar format equals to JSON will have to remove. Now click on this execute. And what it will do that? It will update this. Press F8 and you can see that it has successfully updated the data, because here 204 we are getting the status code. Now go to the person four. Person four has already, you know, retrieved the data, and now he will be having, you know, the entity tag over here. So he is using again, you know, the same entity tag to send the request. So now click on this put, click on this plus, and here if match, here Control V, click on this OK, remove this, right? And let me do one thing. Here, if match, you can see that I have put in a small and a small, right? So this should not create any issue, I believe, but still, you know, for the safer side, so that there should not be any confusion, I'm removing and adding once again. Click on this plus, and I capital F small, M capital A small, and all, right? And Control V. So as usual, I'm doing so that, you know, in the same way how we teach, how we are doing, okay? And here I'm changing now something. So it's let's suppose he is trying to change from AD to PR. Now, will it allow me to change to the user second user, right? It will not allow, because already the first user has changed the data. And now this is not the latest data, right? Now not the latest data, right? So in order to avoid the consistency, right, it will reject. So click on this execute button and see here It will tell you that precondition failed. That means, you know, you don't have the latest data. So system is telling boss, first get the latest data and use the latest entity tag in order to update the data, right? So you got this point, correct? So what this person has to do, that again has to get the latest data, you know, they'll have to, you know, remove the if match and they have to get the latest data. And once they get the latest data, again, you know, again, they will be taking this entity tag and clicking on the plus button. See, if match, I'm putting this time in a small letter, and I think this should also work as per my understanding. Let us see. If it will not work, I will change. Okay. And user request put option, and this time, you know, I will put it 899 only, right? And the latest, you know, you want to change into the PR. Okay. And now click on this execute button, and you can see that it's working, right? So you can see that even if you are having, you know, the small capital does not matter over here. If match, this is not the case sensitive. This also we verified over here. Okay. It's working fine. And if you want to just verify whether this PR got updated or not, simply you can click on this, you know, just first we'll have to remove this and then click on this execute, and you will be able to see that the PR is updated, right? That means it's working fine. So hope you understood the first way of implementing the entity tag using a field of type date, using a field type date time in the table itself. So table field itself I'm using for the purpose of entity tag. Tomorrow I will show you using the hashtag, okay? You can also use hashtag. So by this way also, so we'll see in the more detail, you know, how we can use this, how we can use this one. So this is the second method. So first, this one, this entity tag is the important concept to handle the concurrency control. This is one of the important interview questions also, right? Where the full-fledged OData development is going on, there such kind of things like, you know, the deep insert, get expanded entity set, right? Means the we are having two types of, you know, expand. One is the framework expand, and another is the DPC expand. So DPC framework. So all these kind of like advanced concept you will be using in the OData project, right? So because these are the frequently used concept, this is going to be the important interview question also. So important interview question is nothing but the frequently used concept in the company in the day-to-day, like what's the difference between domain and data element, right? So a person should know what's the difference between domain and data element, right? So similarly, like you can have multiple, like if you are having some good amount of experience, there will be at least like 4 or 5 years of experience, they will be asking what is the update function module, though it is not very frequently used, but sometimes we'll have to use this one, right? Frequently used, what's the difference between table and views, right? So whatever the frequently used concepts are there, those are the VVI question, you know? And again, depends on the depends on your year of experience, right? Fine, with this, let us stop our session. You know, thanks for attending the session and hearing with me the patience. Okay. Any question if you have, just let me know. Okay, good Ramesh. Then thank you. Bye-bye. Let's meet tomorrow.